at that time, as I already told you, Kudur, where I lived, there was no electricity. But there was a park. And in that park, there was a radio. And the radio was connected to a battery and a speaker. And one day, from 7 o'clock and 7:15 in the evening, there was news. From 7:15 to 7:30, there is a program of Telugu light music songs. That is private records, not film music, but private records. There, I heard a song called Sallagalilo, sung by Mr. Rajeswar Rao. It was so fascinating. The voice was so good. And again, he sang with Bala Saraswati, Tummeda. Then all these songs, I was so much fascinated. I used to learn them, sing them in concerts and all that. And I became a fan of him. That is how I became a fan of Rajeswar Rao at that time. That is how first time I got initiated into becoming a fan of Mr. Rajeswar Rao. That is on the music side.
So as I told you, we used to see only in the tent all these films. There was no theater. And also very interesting thing was, whenever there was a Hindi picture, there was a translator. For instance, Mr. Shantaram's Gopal Krishna. It was a wonderful film where Ram Marathe and all the people acted. They are wonderful singers, and that was released. That was shown in the tent theater. And you see, in the center of the tent, one man with the chair will be sitting. As that Hindi dialogues will be going on, he will be translating them into Telugu. So that's how everything it will be going. So lot of people, the moment they buy the ticket, they want to sit nearest the translator so that they can hear the translation also, how it goes. So that is the tent we are having. And at that time, I also saw, as I say, S. C. Rajeswar Rao's person who, that Sallagalilo I heard in that park. I saw a film called Illalu. That was the first film of Rajeswar Rao as the music director. He was only 18. And I still remember all the songs of Illalu. Dina dinamu paapanni devinchi pundi devalokamuloni devatallara devatallara dina dinamu. This is good. Another thing, ee lokapulila natana oka bommalaateya kada vedukayo mari edo ee lokapulila natana oka bommalaateya kada. These are the songs I remember. Only then I heard that those prints are not there, those songs are not there. I don't think anywhere it is available. Only in the memory it may be there. So during that time, one film came. That was Bhakta Potana. Mr. Nagaya acted as Potana. We read about Potana. He is the person who wrote Bhagavatam in Telugu. He was ordered by Sri Rama himself, and he did not give Ankitam, that is, dedicate to any king, was taking the money and all that. The kings used to ask, you dedicated the thing to me. But he said, this is only to God, to Almighty. So we will not give dedicated to anybody. That is the legend goes. So he wrote Bhagavata. Potana was directed by K.V. Reddy. That was K.V. Reddy's first picture as a director. Previously, he was not an assistant director. He was only a production manager in Vahini Pictures. And being a production manager, he is very good in literature. He got a gold medal when he was in Presidency College Intermediate. And he had a lot of film sense. He had the support of people like Mr. Samudrala, Raghavacharlu, the writer, Mr. Ramnath, the great cameraman, and Mr. Sekar, the great art director. These are the people, the stalwarts. Mr. Ramnath is the person who started the Cine Technicians Association first. They are all great people. So he had the support. So with that support, he wrote the screenplay and made this Potana. It was one of the biggest hits. Mr. K.V. Reddy later told me that he was asked at that time, the entire cost of the production of the picture was 1 lakh. And they wanted to know whether his salary either 1000 rupees for the entire picture or 10% of the profits. He preferred 10% of the profits, and finally he got 10,000 rupees. So that was the thing, that was the confidence with which he made that film, he directed that film. And I saw that film as a young boy. I do not know how, I made so many films, but this particular film, I remember right from shot one, exactly how the entire thing goes. I did not know about trolleys, how a pillar goes this way, how a camera is moving, how we move about. So at that time, I did not know anything about trolleys, and from the beginning, every song, every bit, every movement, all the artists, I remembered. And later I saw, and later I saw, and then it was fascinating. At that time, I did not have any idea of getting into films and all that. Only I knew this film fascinated me. The visuals got into my mind very graphically, and this is how I have got into the film appreciation. Then I came to the sixth form, that was the final form. At that time, in the fifth form, sixth form, a very, very strange thing happened in my life. That is, one friend of mine initiated to something called planchette. This planchette means, see, there is a full sheet of paper on which I write alphabets A, B, C, D up to Z in a oval form. And in the meanwhile, I just put a circle and put ohm for what it is worth. And we take a soft cork, the lid of a bottle, cork of a bottle, and put it there, and I put my finger there. And once somebody invokes a spirit, a dead person, into this, that is supposed to get into my hand and move and give an answer. This they said. I wanted to try. So somebody came, somebody called grandfather and all said, said it. So we have, they have a court case or something. When is the court case going to be over? And I put my finger. Actually, the answer came to my mind. I did not know, but I was a boy. So I wanted to know, your case, your means it goes to Y, it goes to O, it goes to U, it goes to R, like that you are. So I used to read, your case will be settled within 6 months. This is what I wrote, I said. Then people thought it was strange, and something, some theft was happened. Somebody asked me, what is the theft? You will get it from the north side within 2 days. And it so happened, they got the thing. Slowly, this news spread that I was a medium between the spirits and myself. Actually, I was thinking in my mind that I was getting it and I was enjoying. The people used to come, ask me questions and all that. Suddenly, it was a tiger by the tail. This talk spread so much, a lot of people started coming in my house. And I used, at 8 o'clock, I have my bath, I put a mat on the floor of the veranda, and have this plank and the thing, people used to come and ask questions. My father also was enjoying, something was happening, who is the spirits and all that. I did not know.
ఏదైనా ఒకటి అనుకుంటే అది ఆలోచించడం ఆలోచించడమే తప్ప చేతిలో నుంచి ఈ గ్లాస్ కూడా పట్టుకో వాళ్ళు ఒక పని చేయలేరు మెంటల్గా ఎంత వర్క్ అన్నా చేస్తారు కానీ వాళ్ళ అలవాటు
ఇప్పటికీ కంటిన్యూ అవుతోంది
ఎప్పటి నుంచి చిన్నప్పటి నుంచి అంతే
ఇప్పటికీ కంటిన్యూ అయ్యి ఇంకా ఎక్కువ అవుతోంది
నౌ వాట్ హ్యాపెండ్ లేటర్ దెర్ వాజ్ ఎ పర్సన్ కాల్డ్ మిస్టర్ బాలకృష్ణారెడ్డి హీ వాజ్ ఎ వాటర్ డివైనర్ ఎ వాటర్ డివైనర్ మీన్స్ యు నో ఇట్ దెర్ ఇస్ ఎ రాడ్ విచ్ గోస్ లైక్ దిస్ అండ్ గోస్ లైక్ దట్ అండ్ కమ్ టూ హ్యాండ్స్ విల్ బి దట్ దే విల్ బి దేర్ And they will be going in a dry land, and because of something that tilts, and they will be able to know the depth of the water, they can dig a well there. And one, that Balakrishna Reddy, he came to me and he said, sir, we have been doing like that, absolutely, we have been trained to do that, somebody told us to do it, but there is only one person, one Mr. Babbitt, B-A-B-E-T. I don't know how to, he is a German. He did a lot of research in this water divining. And he had written a book in German and there is a translation. So I am trying to find where that book is. I am not able to find all libraries, wherever people in the foreign also. I tried that book. It is not available. Can you please invoke Mr. Babbitt, the scientist, and get me some instructions of how to go about this water divine? Immediately everything he said naturally. So the planchette was there. He came and he asked some questions. It was going like that. And he asked a series of questions, some scientific, whatever, I was getting all this in my mind. So I was telling, this is this, if you go to this, this will be there, this will be there, so much or about 3 hour formula. Then he asked something else. I said, you go and find out about this and then come back. He went away. I did not know, I thought, I just, whatever came to my mind, I bluffed. It was fun for me. After 2 months, Mr. Balakrishna Reddy came with a lot of fruits, flowers and all that, as though I was a Swamiji. He gave me and he said, sir, this boy, because of that, I am nearly 10 years richer in my knowledge. All the formula which I did exactly were there. I was able to get the water in that depth and all that. This was a very strange thing. With that, my fame went up. And all the people, whether it is a theft or whether it is a marriage proposal or any psychological thing, and some people, and my father, when I went to Kurnool as a headmaster also, there Mr. Surya Narayana, and he was a, later he became an advocate, Mr. Malakodaya became a collector. They were all at the youngsters at that time. They had a different idea. Instead of asking whether my marriage will be settled, I get a transfer, whether I get a job and all that. Why can't we get some creative people? So, they invoked Shakespeare and wanted him to write a play. And the entire play, one act play called The Last some envelope or the invitation, something like that, it came. It was one act. I played later in the college also. It was about a couple who misplaced their invitation. And they are searching for the invitation, each blaming the other, you should have kept there, you should have kept there. Finally, after about 15, it is a small play, 15-20 minutes. After all that, they find the invitation and they find that the invitation was the previous day, not the day for which they were quarrelling. This was the one act play which was dictated by Shakespeare. It was a strange thing, it was coming into my mind. Probably I may not be able to write the Shakespeare, or it was in me, in my genes, I do not know. Still, it is a very strange thing. At that time, as a schoolboy, I got it. And another person, very strange, is they invoked Mr. Tyagaraja. And one Mr. Pedasubanna, who was a very Carnatic musician, who was teaching a lot of Carnatic music to all the students, he came and he asked Mr. Tyagaraja, can you just sing a new kirtana or kriti? He just gave one pallavi and he wrote it out in swaras. Because I knew swaras also, probably at that time I was thinking it was me. Or today's question is, was it that, or there is some scientific explanation for that? There is something else, something power that is happening. So the song was Nyayamu Ye Dira O Raghurama Nidhu Bhaktulapai Nyayamu Ye Dira. It was in perfect Todi. It was exactly like Tyagarajakruti. They also said, they verify it has got the texture of Tyagaraja. This is what they have said. So all these things are happening. People from other towns were coming. From 1.5 years I was doing like that. But every day I did it. In the night I was feeling exhausted. I did not, after eating some exhaustion, I used to sleep immediately. My father noticed this. Apart from that, I came to 6th form, that is the 10th standard, and I am going to have a public examination. Somehow my father did not like this this way of life, this way of telling all this future, what exactly going to happen, and this type of miracles and all that. My father did not like. He once for all ordered me to stop the entire nonsense. I stopped it in the SSLC because I was facing public examination, and then that was the end of a very interesting period in my life. Then I had public examination, and my aim was, because as I said, Mr. Y. Narasimha Rao trained me in good mathematics, I was always getting 100%, so I wanted to get 100% in my SSLC examination also. But when I was writing, clearing all the paper, that excitement of examination is there. There was a sum in which the answer is 15 by 2, which will be is equal to 7.5. Instead of 7.5, I put it as 5.5 in my hurry. 15 by 2 is 5.5. For that, they cut one mark and they, I got 99 out of 100 in my SLC. That is a sad thing even today. Why I did not get 100? Just because for a silly mistake I made that day, or else I should have got 100. That will be a record. Today I am there at 99. I could not get because of a silly mistake. And I got 408 out of 600. So with that, the school was ended. Now I got in good, very good marks, and I had to go to the college, and I shifted to the college that was in VR College. So now, after passing SSLC, for intermediate, there is no point in going to either Madras or Visakhapatnam, long distance places, and there were very few colleges, and Nellore, which was just 24 miles, that is about the, at those time miles, it was there. So there was VR College and the intermediate was there. For intermediate, we all thought that it was good enough. My parents said it is comfortable. And to stay, my brother's father-in-law, Mr. Udayagiri Srinivasa Rao, he was staying there. So it was comfortable. So they were also happy to look after me. So I shifted, I got a seat in VR College. Mr. Sachidanandam Pillai was the principal at that time. So I stayed in Mr. Udayagiri Srinivasa Rao, his entire family, my sister, they all looked after me extremely well. And from there I used to go to the college. The important things about that college, very little happened in that college, except that our English lecturer was Mr. N.P. Alexander, who later became the governor of Madras. He was the English lecturer at that time. And there are Telugu lecturers like Mr. Dharanikota Venkata Subbaya and another English lecturer called Gurram Subramaya. They all are very highly educated people, literary people, and so we could do learn a lot from them. And one Mr. Vishwesaraya, my friend who later was in Baroda Bank, he was also there. He used to sing K.L. Saigal songs. So he became a star there singing K.L. Saigal songs. So it was actually from 1946 I passed SSLC, and 1946 to 48, 2 years was the intermediate. At that time, the important thing that has happened was, in 1947, August 15th, we got the independence. It was the Independence Day. And my father was at a place called Pudili. He was the headmaster of a middle school. So that was definitely is a holiday, and my father wrote to me, so today, after all the struggle, we have got the independence. It is the first Independence Day. Why do you stay in Nellore? You come, you stay with us, we spend with us. So my mother also is happy. Father and mother, only two people were there. So I went to Pudili to participate in the Independence Day celebrations of the school. So what happened was, as the headmaster, the next day, I went on the 13th or 14th. So next day program was, the flag hoisting was there. Some local leader, he was to do that. They were all small, it's a small village. My headmaster himself was a big, like a governor. And there were some missionaries called Mr. Witter, who were good friends of my father. They all came to have the, to witness the Indian Independence Day, first Indian Independence Day. So there was a group of band people who used to play for all marriages. And they were anxious to play band on that day. So they came to my father, who was the headmaster, and he said, sir, tomorrow is a great day. So on the day of flag, that the time of flag hoisting, we want to play the band. He said, absolutely, it's a pleasure. But only thing is, it was a very small school. We don't have any finances. We will not be able to pay you. What, sir? You mean to say we are going to take money for what we do? Today it's in our Indian Independence Day. To express our joy, we are coming. And they came and everything in the morning, exactly at about 8, 8:30, the flag hoisting is there. There was a flag hoisting, the band was there, everybody clapped. And they played the tune, భారత భూమి మనదే కానీ ఫలితము మనకేది. దిస్ ఇస్ ద బ్యాండ్ దే పిట్. ఇట్ స్టార్ట్స్ విత్ భారత భూమి. ఎవ్రీబడి క్లాప్. ఇట్ వాజ్ ఎ వండర్ఫుల్ నేషనల్ సాంగ్. వి ఆల్ థాట్ అట్ ద ఎంటైర్ ఇండిపెండెన్స్ డే వెంట్ ఆఫ్ వెరీ వెల్. Of course, no radios to hear the exactly how Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister, talked. All those things were not available to us. Only later in the paper, next day, sometime in the afternoon, we could see in the papers. So, no radio facility, nothing those days. But we celebrated that day. Only later in the evening, we realized this Bharata Bhoomi Manade Gani Phalitamu Manikedi, the meaning of it is, in Telugu, it was a freedom struggle song. That is, it starts with Bharata Bhoomi, that is the land of Bharata. Bharata Bhoomi Manade Kani, the Bharata Bhoomi is ours. But where is the result? Phalitamu Manikedi, Phalitam. Where is the result? Because it was in a British regime, the laws were different, the rulers were different. We were ruled by someone else. So the country is ours, but there are no fruits of this ours being our country. All fruits are theirs. So where is the result? But without knowing that, on Independence Day, they sang Bharata Bhoomi Manade Kani, the country is ours, but where is the result? That was a joke at that time. I mean, nobody knew about that. The moment Bharata Bhoomi came, everything, there is not too much of searching for meaning. They thought it was a great national song. But later, when I told my father, we both realized that it was a very funny thing to say on an Independence Day. But now, after so many years, 70 years or 80 years after independence, I think they played very, very correctly. The independence is ours, the country is ours, but where is the result? It is as good. In the British days, the same poverty, the same thing, same hardships, even much worse, too much of corruption, too much of nepotism, too much of radio, red tape, all these things are there. The country is not at all improved, the same there. Where is the result? The Gandhiji and Nehru, they have all got us the freedom. Where is the result? That is the song they played on that day. We thought it was a joke. Now I think how truthful they are, because though the country is ever, our governments are not giving the citizens anything. That is the result today. So that is how my intermediate has finished. And then I got through the intermediate.
నీవు ఆర్ఎస్ఎస్ లో పని చేసావు కదా, అది తెలుసా నీకు? చెప్పొద్దు, చెప్పకూడదు.
చెప్పు.
చెప్పేనా? అది ఎప్పుడు? నీవు ఇక్కడ చదివేటప్పుడు, ఎఫ్ఏ చదివేటప్పుడు నీవు మా రాముడు ఇద్దరు ఆర్ఎస్ఎస్కి వస్తే మీ అమ్మ తగుబడారు. అంతంత పెద్దవాళ్ళతో నీకేమి ఇట్లా స్నేహం అని అడిగితే ఏం లేదులే అమ్మ అనేసి వెళ్ళిపోయాడు. కర్రలు అవంతా తీసుకొని అలానాసా గుడి దగ్గర చేస్తూ ఉండేవాళ్ళు. చేస్తూ ఉంటే అప్పుడు వీళ్ళనంతా బండిలో ఎక్కించి విజయవాడ మీటింగ్ అని తీసుకొని వెళ్ళిపోయారు. వీళ్ళని ఏం చేశారు? అప్పటికే కొంచెం గలాట అయింది. వీళ్ళని కావులు యువతల కావుల్లోనే అక్కడ దింపేశారు. వీళ్ళని ఎవరు? మా రాముడు తను ఇద్దరు దింపారు. మిగిలిన వాడందరూ విజయవాడకి వెళ్ళిపోయారు. అక్కడ చాలా గలాటాలు అయ్యి వాళ్ళనంతా అడవిలో వదిలేశారు.
గాంధీ గారు పోయారు. అది విషయం,
అది సంగతి.
ఆయన
ఆయన పట్టుకున్నారు. ఆయనకేం సంబంధం లేదట. అక్కడ ఉన్నాడని ఆయన పట్టుకున్నారు, జైల్లో పెట్టారు.
అది
తర్వాత ఏమంటే వీళ్ళని దించేస్తే అప్పుడు వీళ్ళకి ఛార్జీ లేదు. ఎట్టొచ్చారో వస్తే స్టేషన్లో కూర్చో ఉంటే మా నాయన వచ్చి వీళ్ళు వాళ్ళకి డబ్బు కట్టి ఏదో తెలియలేదు పిల్లలు వచ్చారని వీళ్ళిద్దరిని విడిపించుకొని తీసుకొని వెళ్ళిపోయారు. చిన్నవాళ్ళు వీళ్ళిద్దరూ, డబ్బు లేదు, అక్కడ దించేశారు. ఎట్లొచ్చారో వాళ్ళు వచ్చేసారు. నెల్లూరులో స్టేషన్లో పోము, ఆ స్టేషన్ మాత్రం పట్టేసుకున్నాడు వీళ్ళిద్దరిని. ఇంకా మాకైతే ఎంత దిగులు అంటే దిగులు. మా అత్తగారు ఇంకా ఏమి, అసలు ఎట్లా అయిపోయిందో అట్లా అయిపోయింది ఆమెకు పని. తర్వాత వీళ్ళని ఎట్టనో విడిపించుకొని మా నాయన కూడా తిట్టారు అందరినీ, ఎందుకు రా మీరు ఇటువంటి పనులు చేశారు అట్లా ఎట్లా అని చెప్పేసి గలాట అయిపోయింది. అది అయిపోయింది. అది అయిన తర్వాత
మళ్ళీ రామస్వామిరావు,
రామస్వామిరావుని జైల్లో పెట్టారు.
ఆయన జైల్లో పెట్టారు.
పెట్టారు
అదే టైంలో. ఆయన సూరి అని, సూరి హనుమడు,
సూరి అతను మేనల్లుడు,
మేనల్లుడు
హనుమడు సూరి
కొడుకు.
వాళ్ళని అడవిలో వదిలేశారు. సూర్య ఎట్టాకో చాలా రోజులకు వచ్చాడు, హనుమడు తొందరగా వచ్చాడు.
and now to go to the next degree level. There are two options. The college, next college for a degree was only in Visakhapatnam or in Chennai, Presidency College. Chennai is very near, at that time Madras. So where to go? So Visakhapatnam, my father's brothers, they were all there, we could go to Visakhapatnam. But we preferred Chennai, we preferred Madras, and I came, I was in my uncle's house, and I applied along with another friend of mine, Mr. R. Sripati Naidu. He later became a librarian in Sri Venkateswara University, chief librarian. So we both came and we applied. First we got a seat in Pachapas College, we did not get a seat in Presidency College. But later, after 1 week or 10 days, we just met the principal, one Mr. Dr. Abdul Haq. But it seems there was suddenly vacancy, something was filled. He immediately gave us the seats and we joined the Presidency College and we wanted to join the Victory Hostel. Now the life in Presidency College and the life in Victory Hostel will start as a big episode next.